What's going on? I Hate Average Podcast. I'm back, another episode, another week. Last week we had Thomas Knox from Date While You Wait. Great interview, a lot of insight. We talked about the human connection and how he got started with this project of Date While You Wait. A lot of fun. Also, we talked about how he's gonna branch off and you know, further the human connection, further the initiative. Definitely check out that episode if you haven't. Also check out his website, Date While You Wait. This week we got Buddy. He's an artist coming out of Brooklyn. He has a new single, so I wanted to support this brother and get him on the show. The new single is I'm Broke Baby. You know the line from Paid in Full. Once I heard that, I was kind of feeling the connection, so I wanted to get him on the show and get the song on the show, so you guys, you know, let me know if you like it or not. So, at the end of this interview with Buddy, we're going to put the single. All right, everyone, I'm here with Buddy. He's a recording artist coming out of New York. What's going on, man?
What's going, man? How are you, man? Thank you for having me, man.
No problem. Great. So, I heard your song, I'm Broke Baby. It brought me back to the Paid in Full movie and I like that feel. So when you come up with that single,
man, I was just looking for, you know, I'm working on a project right now, more than a mixtape coming soon, man, to get off topic a little bit. But okay. I was just looking for that club feel. I had the street songs, I had, you know, the motivational song, I had everything else. I was just looking for that club thing. I found that beat and that beat just made me feel like, yo, I'm broke, baby. And it went through, man. It came out perfect, man. I didn't even expect it to come out like that, man. Just everybody just bought into it, man. Yeah. Everybody fucking with it, man. Excuse my language.
No, curse, man. Feel free.
So, yeah, man, everybody started fucking with it, man. I'm just happy, man.
Yeah, it got a good summer feel to it, bringing New York City back. I like the feel. So what how long you been rapping, and what made you want to start this project, more than a mixtape project?
Well, I've been rapping since I was about 14, 15, probably a little earlier than that, but okay. I never took it serious. At the beginning, I was on my battle and shit. You know, battling everybody. You know, high school beating on the table, lunchroom battles, and like, you know, that's where I started from. Is like, at first I was shy to rap. I'm walking around with a whole book full of raps, and nobody never knew I rap, not even my friends. Uh-huh. You know, until, you know, one day in the lunchroom, everybody started talking. I started battling about 7 different people. First battle, first time ever even letting people hear me rap, but. And it's like, you know, I went from there. I linked up with my man SG, my man Big. Shouts to them, man. Rush Boys, what up? Four Green, what up? You know, so we started, you know, not taking it serious, but like, fuck it, let's put some songs together. So now we in the studio all the time. I still wasn't taking it serious. My man SG was going harder than all of us, whatever.
Okay.
But then, you know, I took a little break. You know, it's like, you know, a little few tensions started going on with like my inner circle. So it's like, I'm a type of nigga, if that's going to fuck up my circle, then I'm going to just fall back from it. I'm going to let you go hard, you know, for my man, that's G. So, it's like, you know, I fell back from the music then. I just started hearing a bunch of garbage on the radio. I rarely listen to the radio, man. Like, I just started hearing a bunch of garbage. And then one of my men, he compared me. Now, I'm not even going to mention the artist, but he's like, yo, such and such better than you. I said, don't play with me like that, man. I kid you not. Don't play with me like that. He said, yo, they ragged that. I'm like, yo, that verse was trash. Yo, they ragged that. I'm sorry. I'm going to show you now. This, honestly speaking, this is like 3-4 months ago.
Yeah.
And ever since then, I'm like, you know what? I guess, you're not better. When you unsigned, nobody going to say you better than the person that signed until you sign. You know, they don't respect it.
Of course.
You know, when you ain't making no money out of it, so.
Yeah.
I said, you know what? I'm going to show niggas what it is, man. So.
Definitely.
About 3-4 months, I've just been going super hard, and, like, the buzz just got crazy, man.
That's great, man. That's great. I'm glad, you know, you're following your passion and you're going with it, man. Hopefully, you might have some bumps and bruises going along the way, but just don't stop, man. Don't stop.
Yeah, of course. Everything, every grind, no matter what, I don't give a fuck what you're doing. A 9-to-5, that shit come with bumps and bruises. You have your good days, you have your bad days. So I'm here for it, man.
I feel you, man. All right. So you said I think you mentioned Fort Greene when you was talking about your past. So you from Brooklyn?
Yeah, Brooklyn, man. Shout out to Fort Greene, shout out to Brownsville, man.
Okay.
East New York. So, from everywhere, but you know, mainly Brooklyn, man.
Definitely. I know that's just it's very competitive over there, especially in the hip hop world. I know it's very competitive over there.
Tell me about it. Word, man, you know, but you can't hate on the next person. So.
Oh, nah, definitely.
Man. Everybody do their thing, man. Everybody got to ease enough money out here for everybody, man.
Absolutely, I definitely agree, man. So, what's somebody, people who like kind of inspired you, you know, some styles that you kind of, you know, gravitated to when you first started rapping?
When I first, my teenage years, I was a Banks fan. I was a big Banks fan.
Yeah.
Lloyd Banks, man. Like,
he's definitely underrated, man. He's underrated.
Yeah, he's very underrated, man. Like, and then, you know, Jada, you know, Jay. But far as, like, with my style, punchlines, everything, like, I was just Jada, Banks, you know, Cassidy here and there.
Okay.
Then, you know, Fab, you know, that's just like that era right then and there. But I was always, you know, big Biggie fan, man.
Of course. So when can we start looking out for this More Than a Mixtape project?
More Than a Mixtape. We're in July. I give it beginning of August.
Okay.
I'm trying to do it. My birthday, August 6th, so that may be my birthday gift to everybody, man. More Than a Mixtape, something special, man.
Definitely. Sounds great, man. Looking forward to it, man. I'm definitely feeling your passion. So how's the ladies feeling the music so far, man?
I mean, shout out to my girlfriend, man. But, you know... They, you know how that goes, but, you know, I just got to have strong will. That's
it. Of course.
But, you know, all shows, I'm bringing her with me.
Yeah, definitely,
Miami, I've got the Miami trip. I perform out there and Labor Day weekend.
Oh, wow, out there, man.
With me, but she know what it is, though, man. Long gone, disrespect her.
Of course, yeah, of course.
That's it, but ladies, they rocking with me, man.
Okay, so where are you gonna be performing in Miami? Where can people look out for that?
The performance is gonna be August 31st,
okay,
at Miami Live.
Nice.
And Sunday again at Miami Live.
Nice. Yeah, that's
gonna... There's a big music convention out there, so
okay,
gotta be performing twice out there.
Nice.
Yeah.
It's good to get that look outside of New York. That's a good look.
Exactly. Then I got another show coming up July 29th at the Blue Room Lounge in Jersey, Secaucus, Jersey.
Okay.
So that's like 10-minute drive as soon as you get out the tunnel.
That's what's up, man. So you've been looking to get signed, or you want to take the independent route?
I mean, the independent route, you know, that's more money, but it depends, man. It's like these labels right now, the labels, like, it's slowly dying out right now because everybody doing their independent thing, like, you know, because that's pretty much where all the money you got. The labels, they're going to dig in your pocket, but
of course.
My thing is if they present something to the table, if they come to the table right, then, you know, I got to do what I got to do, but I'm not just, you know, taking anything because my thing is once they start hollering at me, I mean, my name is already up, so I could try the independent route.
Of course.
So, nah, that go. But like I said, if they come at me right, then we talk business.
Definitely, man. But I'm glad to see that you really, you know, you're going the route of, you know, getting your name out outside of New York. Because I know a lot of people, you know, they try to stick with the five boroughs, trying to get their name buzzing in New York. But it's you know, it's kind of the New York music scene is kind of weird. So it's better to get buzzed outside of New York, and then it comes back.
Exactly. You know, we from New York. You know how New York is. New York not gonna love you until somebody else loves you.
Exactly. So, 100%, man.
That's how that goes. So it's like, you know, once they see you popping elsewhere, they're gonna be like, "Guy, now we can fuck with him. Now we're good. Now you know how that goes, man. The home team never vouch for you, man. But
until you up,
they ain't got no choice but to respect it, man.
Yeah, definitely, man. So. So how did you said you've been taking it serious in a couple months, so how did you make the connections to start doing shows?
I just started like putting my freestyles out.
Okay.
Freestyles out on Instagram. You know, a few people hollering at me, you know, seeing a few ads out there.
Okay.
Like, yo, you got a showcase coming up here, who wanna perform? I'm on everything. Hey, boom. All right, let me click on that. Let me sign up for that.
Yeah.
All right, let me click on that. Let me sign up for that. And then, like I said, people hand freestyles and certain songs, they start reaching out to me like, yo, what's up? Can I book you? Yeah. Hey, can I book you there? All right, let's go. However I'm going to get my name out, that's what I'm going to do.
Definitely, man. Definitely. I'm feeling that grind, and you kind of inspire me, man.
Yeah, man. I'm telling you, man. I appreciate it, man.
So the morning the mixtape, is it gonna be something that you're gonna be trying to sell, or are you just gonna put it out there for the people?
Nah, I'm gonna put it out there. I'm not even going, you know, try to profit off that.
Okay.
I'm gonna put it out there. Like, it is what it is, man. Like, it's my first project. I can't, you know, sell it to them. And you know, I gotta get them first. I gotta lure them in.
Of course,
once
of course.
Lure them in, then you know. But other than that, that's given for free, man. Like I said, it's what the title is about, man. It's more than the next thing. No industry beats on there.
Hmm.
No, none. Everything is a straight original. It's like it's not like your average mixtape freestyles, and this is gonna be something special, man.
Okay.
I got a few bangers on there.
Definitely, man. So you got your own producer, or you just been people just been presenting stuff to you?
Nah, I got a few people, man. Shout out to my man A2 on the beat. I got a few people that be, you know, just be sending me beats, whatever. They start liking shit, you know, they be like, yo, I got something for you. I hit a few people up. You know, I go on YouTube and I snatch a beat up. But then that's once I go on YouTube, snatch a beat up, I look at the name, whatever, and I'm finding them on social media. Like, yo, what's up? What's good with this beat? It's still available. I want it. You know, whatever they charge, they charge.
Yeah.
That's it.
That's what's up, man. Definitely. Thank you so much for your time, man. I'm really, really feeling your grind. I appreciate it, man.
Yeah, thanks a lot, man.
Yeah, so you said early August we should be looking out for that mixtape, right?
Yeah, early August, man. By that time, you know, I keep in contact with you.
Okay, of course,
Know, when it's dropped, you know, we do a second interview, part two.
It sounds great to me, man. Sounds great. So just tell people how they can reach out to you, man.
Instagram, buddy_stay tuned. That's buddy_stay tuned. Twitter. Buddy_stay tuned, the same thing. Facebook, Laquan Buddy Davis. You know, I'm joking around on that. But as far as music, you know, everything, that's buddy_stay tuned. And, you know, I got the fan page as well. You know, buddy_stay tuned, fan page, whatever. But like I said, as far as music, you go to my page, buddy_stay tuned. And that's it, man. You know about all up-and-coming shows. I got a bunch of freestyles on there, whatever. So, you know, just hit me up, man.
Definitely, man. Definitely. I appreciate it. Thanks for your time, man. Definitely people got to check out these upcoming shows in Jersey and Miami. And I can't wait for this mixtape. And definitely, like you said, we got to do a part two.
Yeah, exactly, man. Because I'm about to really hit the streets up. But this next John got talks with Big. Like, me and Big having a whole conversation. Like,
that's crazy. Oh, say. Of course, that's the Brooklyn love. That's the Brooklyn love.
Exactly.
Yeah. All right, man. So, thanks again for your time and have a good night.
Nah, shorty. You're gonna need to buy your own drinks today. Nah. Put that cup down. Last time I gave y'all a drink, you and your 10 friends left me with a whole empty bottle. No. Yo, bang. Get them out my section.
Tell them bring the bottles, they can keep the stuff.
Keep it.
Tell the owner bring it, I don't need them. Cause I'm broke, baby, I'm broke, baby.
I ain't got it.
I'm broke, baby, I'm broke, baby.
These
bitches want a nigga in his bag. Now these bitches, they just try to get a bag. I'm broke, baby, I'm broke, baby.
Bitches smelling that money on the walk-in. The way we pull up like that money on a forklift. Money flying, bottles coming, we go all in. That's how I look in the VIP full of bosses. Niggas hating, they bitches see how we act out. Take a selfie, trying to catch us in the background. I sent Dick to tell her, come and take a team picture. Now he bought all them drinks and they gon' leave with her. Standing on the couch like where my man is at. A bunch of strippers, they wondering where them dancers at. Why he be lurking, I'm trying to stay from the camera flash. But I'm steady trying to smack the panda off a panda ass. Shorty whisper in my ear, tell me your rent due. I tell her, baby, I'm struggling, I got rent too. She said she running low on her kids food. I just want to hear that ass clap, now what you been through?
Tell her bring the bottles, they can keep the sparkles. Tell her I wanna bring it, I don't need the money. Cause I'm broke, baby, I'm broke, baby.
I ain't got it.
I'm broke, baby, I'm broke, baby.
Baby, baby.
These bitches want a nigga in his bag.
Uh-huh.
Now these bitches, they just tryna get a bag. I'm broke, baby, I'm broke, baby. I'm broke, baby, I'm broke, baby.
Champagne showers from all the dirty money. Got me tossing it like I ain't got no purpose for it. I spend it and getting doubled, I ain't hurting from it. A nigga wavy, they ride me like they surfing on me. Whoa. Big ballers, I ain't talking triple B's. For a walkthrough, promoters got a triple B's. Cause soon, nigga, I ain't doing shit for free. Cause when I needed them, they ain't do shit for me. I just spent somebody rent money. And that's only the bartender tip money. Just imagine what this whole club getting from me. A couple dances, they gon' take a couple trips on me. Shorty telling me about a student loan. I tell her, get up on that floor, get the moving up. This money getting tossed around for everybody. It's love day, I'm giving love to everybody.
Tell her bring the bottles, they can keep the sparkles. Tell her I wanna bring it, I don't need the money. Cause I'm broke, baby, I'm broke, baby.
I ain't got it.
I'm broke, baby, I'm broke, baby. These bitches wanna make it in this bag. I'm broke, baby. Tell them bring the bottles, they can keep the sparkles.
Keep it.
Tell them I wanna bring it, I don't need the money. Cause I'm broke, baby, I'm broke, baby.
I ain't got it.
I'm broke, baby, I'm broke, baby. These bitches want a nigga in his bag. Now these bitches, they just tryna get it back.
There you go. That's my interview with Buddy. I Hate Average Podcast. Did you like the record? Did you like the I'm Broke Baby, I'm Broke Baby? Was you feeling it? Let him know. Contact him. Let me know. I could let him know. Thank you for the continued support this week. Next week, we got another great guest. I'm actually about to go on vacation, but he's still going to put out these episodes. I'm trying to stay on track. We're taking this a little bit more serious this year. We up it a notch. We raising the bar, as they say. So thank you for your continued support. Of course, you can always email me, j@averagej.com. Once again, it's jay@averagej.com. You can hit me up on social media, Instagram, I Hate Average Podcast, Snapchat, I Hate Average JAY. And let's continue to connect, and you know, I could put out more content. You guys could show me what you guys want to know, what you don't like about the show. And